वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल। और आज बहुत दिनों बाद हे गाइस बोले कितना सही लग रहा है।
हमने बहुत मिस किया आप लोगों को एंड आपके लिए इंफॉर्मेशनल वीडियोस बनाना हमें बहुत पसंद है।
Right, so this video is not for posto and after a long while we have come with an informational video that you guys will surely find helpful.
Yes, so हमने recently युवान का OCI apply किया था and there were a lot of questions, lot of discrepancies, what I confusion थी regarding the paperwork and because it is such an important document, तो हम चाहते थे कि ये सारी information आप लोगों के साथ share करें.
And we actually got the OCI 2 days back. So we thought that why not create a video for all our subscribers, because we saw a lot of our friends were also asking as to what the process is and how to go about this entire application. So here's how we got the OCI for Posto.
Who's gonna go to India now? So application ke liye first cheez jo required hai wo hai aapka passport. तो पासपोर्ट एप्लीकेशन के लिए हमने एक और वीडियो बनाई थी विच यू मस्ट हैव सीन, और अगर नहीं देखी है तो अभी देख लो उसको। कॉन्सुलेट जनरल ऑफ इंडिया की पार्टनरशिप है विद अ वेंडर कॉल्ड BLS इंटरनेशनल सर्विसेज। यहीं पर हमारे को अपनी OCI एप्लीकेशन सबमिट करनी होती है और यहीं से आपकी एप्लीकेशन फॉरवर्ड होती है टू कॉन्सुलेट जनरल ऑफ इंडिया।
नाउ वी हैव डिवाइडेड दिस वीडियो इनटू 4 डिफरेंट सेगमेंट्स। व्हाट आर द फॉर्म्स दैट नीड्स टू बी फिल्ड अप फॉर द एप्लीकेशन, द डॉक्यूमेंट्स दैट यू नीड टू प्रोवाइड इन ऑर्डर टू गेट द OCI, द एप्लीकेशन फी एंड द टाइमलाइन फॉर दिस एंटायर प्रोसेस।
तो सबसे पहले लेट्स सी व्हाट आर द फॉर्म्स दैट नीड टू बी फिल्ड अप।
तो सबसे पहले वी विल लॉग इन टू द BLS इंटरनेशनल वेबसाइट। वहाँ पे एक टैब होगा OCI का, जिसमें आप क्लिक करोगे तो आपको एक OCI का ऑप्शन मिलेगा। दिस इज़ द OCI इंफॉर्मेशन पेज। इट विल गिव यू ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन हाउ टू अप्लाई फॉर ओवरसीज सिटीजनशिप ऑफ इंडिया। माई रिकमेंडेशन इज दैट जस्ट गो थ्रू इट एंड रीड थ्रू ऑल द पॉइंट्स दैट आर मेंशनड ओवर हियर। नेक्स्ट यू कैन क्लिक ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड ऑफ द पेज वेयर द OCI इज मेंशनड। यहाँ पे आपको एक इन्फॉर्मेशन पेज मिलेगा जहाँ पे रिवाइज गाइडलाइंस फॉर OCI एप्लीकेंट्स है। दिस इज द जनरल इन्फॉर्मेशन। देन वी हैव रिक्वायरमेंट्स, फी, प्रोसेसिंग टाइम एंड फॉर्म्स एंड चेकलिस्ट टैब्स। इफ यू स्क्रोल डाउन यू कैन सी सम जनरल इन्फॉर्मेशन और ज्यूरिसडिक्शन की डिटेल्स हैं। जैसे कि हमारा एप्लीकेशन वॉज बेस्ड आउट ऑफ ऑन्टारियो, तो BLS एप्लीकेशन सेंटर दैट इज एप्लीकेबल फॉर अस इज टोरंटो, विनिपेग और ब्रैम्पटन। सो यू कैन चेक योर BLS एप्लीकेशन सेंटर लाइकवाइज। एंड जनरल इन्फॉर्मेशन। सो नेक्स्ट वी गो टू द रिक्वायरमेंट्स टैब। इसमें डॉक्यूमेंट रिक्वायरमेंट्स हैं, व्हाट आर द डिटेल्स इन द पार्ट ए एंड पार्ट बी ऑफ द फॉर्म दैट नीड टू बी फिल्ड अप एंड अदर डिटेल्स लाइक व्हाट आर द फोटोग्राफ रिक्वायरमेंट्स एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट। सो दिस इज पार्ट ए एंड पार्ट बी। दिस इज बाय क्लिकिंग दिस लिंक वी विल बी एबल टू एक्सेस द पार्ट ए ऑफ द एप्लीकेशन एंड पार्ट बी विल बी फिल्ड आफ्टर वी आर डन फिलिंग द पार्ट ए। एंड वंस दिस इज filled up, we need to submit the documents based on the OCI checklist. Just read through this when you go through it. Now click here. This is the online OCI services for the Consulate General of India page. Just accept all of this, then click here to proceed. And now since this is a new OCI registration, just read through this before you start what all you need to do. And here are the prerequisites, what are the photograph and the signature requirements that you have for the documents that you need to upload, and also for the supporting documents in PDF format, and what are the steps that you need to do after the registration. Now when we click on proceed, here are some details that need instructions that need for the filling of the application form. I can just go through, you can go through it at your own pace. So here we will enter the captcha and click on enter. So once you enter the details, you can click save and continue when you are done filling the application form. Now this is page 2 where applicant address details need to be entered. If you see here, we have the temporary application ID, so you can access your application if it's partially filled. So once you've entered all these details over here, you can click on next. And here you can verify your information, applicant information, family, passport and residential address. If you want to modify, click here and you can submit it if all looks good. So now you see a file reference number has been generated and part A of the application has been filled up. So now after uploading your image and signature, we can go to part B of the application. So I would recommend get the photograph and the signature ready based on the format mentioned over here. And you can click on yes, I am ready with the image. So over here, you can select the image file from your local machine. And you can crop the image based on the selection that you need to do. Oh my God, he's looking so cute in this picture. Haha. Okay, so now signature, you can select the signature file and crop it based on the location that you want to select and click on upload. Just ensure that the aspect ratio and everything is just correct. And once you verify, you can just see if you want to upload it again. And if not, you can select I have uploaded successfully. Now you have the option of proceeding to part B, or you can exit it and come back with the same file reference number. Let's go to part B of the form. Here, other details of the applicant is required. You can just go through these yes and no questions. For us, all of these were no, so we could easily proceed. And then your present nationality details. How was your present nationality acquired? And what was the date of acquisition? And then the other details, like if there are any previous nationality or then next is, do you have any relatives staying in India? We have yes. And then you can give the name, present address, relationship and age of that member. And has the applicant faced criminal proceedings? No. So once you've filled in all the details, you can just click on submit. And here you go. Your OCI application is done, part A and part B. Now the only thing is left, that is upload of documents. And you can click on this. And you can select the document type to upload if it is current passport, employment letter, Indian origin proof, etc, etc. And based on what document you select, you can choose the file from your local machine again and click on upload. So if you don't have any documents available at hand, you can always come back to this application, and based on this web file number, you can easily access the application and upload the documents later. So that's it. That's all you need to do.
Ye to ho gaya ki how you are going to fill up the application forms. Now the next part is as to what documents need to go in to support the application. Aur iske liye hum log chalenge BLS ke website pe. Checklist bilkul clearly bataya hua hai and we are going to take a look at that.
So BLS ki website pe on the forms and checklist tab, you will see all the checklists available for different jurisdictions. For us, Toronto jurisdiction checklist made sense. So this is the Toronto checklist for OCI application. It has online application important guidelines. So it tells you how to fill out the online form and you can just go through all of this. I would recommend you can take a printout of this checklist, and based on your application and what all details you need to enter and what all documents you need to provide, you can take a look. At the end of each page, there is a place to sign. So I would recommend you sign it and include this in the application that you send to the BLS center. So the supporting documents we provided for our applicant was a completed online form, that is Form A and Form B, like I just showed. The Canadian passport photocopy, the birth certificate copy of the applicant, which is in the long form. One photograph, which is 51 mm by 51 mm. And for the mother and father of the applicant, we need to provide the below documents: an Indian passport photocopy, the PR card photocopy, the landing document or COPR copy. If the parents are Canadian passport holders, below are the documents that are required with the application: an Indian passport surrender certificate copy, a cancelled Indian passport copy, Canadian citizen certificate copy, Canadian passport copy, and the landing document COPR copy. And there are also some additional documents that we need to provide with the application, which include address proof copy of any parent, marriage certificate copy. This is only required if your spouse's name is not available on your passport, and a no objection certificate that needs to be signed by both the parents. I will leave a link of this document in the description box below. Please note that all the documents need to be self-attested with signature and date at the bottom of each document. and these wordings need to be mentioned on each signature. I certify this to be a true copy of the original document.
So, ab baat karte hain processing fee ke bare mein.
On the BLS website under the fee tab, we will be able to see the processing fee for different modes of payment for different jurisdictions.
There are two types of fee that need to be submitted for this OCI application.
For the Toronto jurisdiction, the application fee is $425 and this needs to be paid via a demand draft payable to Consulate General of India, Toronto. There is a BLS service fee of $740 which is payable to BLS International Services Canada and this also needs to be paid via a bank draft.
Now let us take a look as to how long it took for the processing of our OCI application.
So these are the processing timelines for our application. We submitted the application to BLS on 7th January and we received the OCI via Purolator on 12th of February. So the BLS processing time is around 2 to 3 business days and the CGI processing time is 4 to 6 weeks.
So guys, I hope you find the video very, very helpful and thank you for all your support to our channel. And we can't wait to see your comments as to how this entire video went. And do let us know if you have any questions. Till then,
bye-bye.